Welcome back to our series on rapid wireframing. My name is Billy Carlson. I'm a design educator here at Balsamiq. In this video, we're going to talk about diving into wireframes and basically creating a set of mid-fidelity wireframes. So the first thing I'm going to do is select which of these thumbnail wireframes I want to go with. And I'm going to do is find them, pick them, and then make a copy and create a new wireframe page and start designing. So I selected them by holding down the shift key and on an Apple, a command key. On a PC, that would be the control key. So I'm allowed to select multiple things. I'm going to go to edit, copy. I don't have to keep them selected anymore. Just create a new page. I'm going to rename it. I don't think I showed you how to rename yet, but it's as simple as highlighting on it, clicking rename, and I'm going to type mid fidelity wireframes and hit enter. All right, now I'm going to use my keyboard and hit Command V and paste it in there and start designing. So one of the things you notice, and if we look to the inspector panel, this is 230 by 378. That's not going to be my target size. It'll be much bigger. I want it to be proportional to what I'm actually going to build. What I'm going to do is start designing these. Actually, I probably need to give myself some space here because they'll be three times the size. So I want to comment too that I will eventually make these their own separate wireframes, but right now I'm going to be using a lot of the elements across the design, and it's easier if I do it all in one canvas and then separate them in a more of a refinement stage and in a prototyping stage. Now the next thing is going to start with a restaurant listing. I selected this one. I felt like it's more accessible as a designer where it has both an image of a logo and the restaurant name and the type of food so that someone's going to easily connect with the logo. They know it. It's well known. Or they're going to be able to read what the words are saying. So I'm actually going to copy. I'm going to paste with Command or Control V. All I'm going to do is just size it to the width that I have established here. I left a nice border. This is 475. This is going to be 415. And then just select, hold on the shift, select that. And then this one right in here, it says align center. Now it's aligned in the center. You can see just me taking this design and then scaling it up. I'm really close to what I want to be. This is going to be my restaurant's listing. Eventually, I'll need a back button. There's a few ways you can do a back button. I'm going to do one within the text because this is my favorite way to use it. If you use markdown type communications, you hit a colon, you can bring in icons. So mine is going to be arrow, and I type in arrow and I can find what kind of arrow I want. I'm really picky. Again, shocking. I'm a designer. I'm really picky about arrows. I love these kind of arrows. I don't need the back button right now. I'm just sort of demoing how to do it because I'll use it on the next screen, right? That eventually will be what it is. And that really does stand out. So instead of having it be orange, it'll be dark gray. And that's fine. So this is what eventually my back button will be. It doesn't stand out. Another way I can do this is making this white and something like that. A lot of times the back button is on the top left, right? And as long as I put something there and make it very clear what it is, people will know. I don't need that right now, but what I could use is a cart, right? So I can type in cart. I don't know what to use. You know, if you're trying to be cute and say like a food tray or something, but people think e-commerce, they think cart. So I'm just going to stick with that. I'm just going to pick a shopping cart and I'm going to type in cart. There's so many options. I want it to be nice and simple, but you can add color right in here by using color colon white and close. And I'll put a number 7, lucky number 7, close, color 7. I'm going to add some space here and do something fancy where I will put a shape. It could be any color and move it back. Now we have this sort of like badge thing here, right? I can do it multiple ways, but to me, it's easier to do it in line because I can just edit whatever I want by this whole thing could be editable. Okay. I see this as like a restaurant logo. You know, think of it as a marketing tile. I think that's the proper phrase to use, because it could be a logo, it could be anything. But I wanted it to have some color again, maybe even a deeper color, because it'll be more distracting than we're going to imagine it is. And that'll let us understand how to design for the rest of it. Right now, I don't need this, but I can copy these and move them down a little bit for later. Okay, so you're going to go. And this is what it looks like for now. And then let's start working on the actual restaurant listings. What I mentioned on the previous wireframe is I liked having the categories like this. So I'm actually copy these. This is a thing for me. I have younger kids. Hamburgers or chicken tenders. They're not super adventurous, except for Annie, who will eat sushi with me. Thanks, Annie. Okay, so I wanted to make it big enough for me to think of tapping. Okay, so I did that. And I made them different sizes because they're not going to be all the same size. And now I'll just put some content into it. I do like this this look. They don't have anything on it. I might go there and then do that. I'm just making some stuff at this point. This isn't final for us, right? Tacos. I live in Southern California now. Poke is huge. So is tacos and sushi. And I'm just doing types of food. It may be offered at multiple restaurants, and you can choose which restaurant you want to go to. And we'll just do pizza and something else. Here, it's not centered. It just looks. So you just use the centering of the text. You select, hold on the shift and select this, and then use the centered so you know it's really centered in there. I'll leave poke at the end and do pizza here. I'm from Chicago area. We like our pizza. Very much into that. Okay, so that's just categories. Again, this is me just saying, like, what do I think? Like, you guys start somewhere, and I'm going to continue. I notice a lot of times they do featured. And then we can do alphabetical. And what we're doing is we're labeling these sections. So if I want to do something like sushi, it would say sushi and show all the places that have sushi. I like this idea. Interesting. So this would stay an image. This would be featured. So let's just say it's Philly's Pizza Palace, because I love pizza. And I notice this is pretty big. Proportionally, I can only fit a few words in there. So maybe that will have to change with knowing what restaurants would go in there. But this text could be a lot smaller. In Chicago, we have pizza pubs. You should be jealous. So one of the things I'm looking at here is I don't want the text to be too crammed. I know this is a wireframe, but I still want to think of the proportions. And that's something that you learn from experience of how you place the text. So now this would be a restaurant card. This would be some sort of imagery. It could be a slice of pizza or my logo, and then explaining exactly what it is. So for the rest of these, I don't have to fill them in with real content yet. I'll do the first four. What I'm doing is copying them. You see how I can quickly make designs using the same patterns. And then we'll just do lorem ipsum, because let's move on, right? Okay, so this could be it. And then what would happen is that there would just be more down here. You can design this in a way where you can make this screen as long as you want and putting all the content in there, but we're not there yet. We don't need to do that unless if there's other things that go on the screen that we're missing. We're only designing like this set, and we're going to show people this set so that they can kind of see what we're doing. Okay, so we will continue designing. And what we're going to do is take the same style, see how they sort of match across, and continue designing for it. So one of the things you notice here is that smaller restaurant logo with the restaurant name. And so that we have more room for the menu, right? The important stuff. So I'm purposely using this color here to, it's going to stand out when it's on the screen. So don't try to hide it now. Categories of the menu items. And then following the same design patterns, just select everything, hold option and shift and slide it over. And then we'll put it in its final position here. And I'm just going to copy this text, holding in the option and put in the name of the place. And it should be bigger now that we've selected it, and it's easier for me to read it on the screen and to make sure that I'm not confused of where I'm ordering from, make it obvious, right? And this will be categories of the menu. So if you want to quickly select which one you want to go to, once I set the styles up, it'll be much easier for me to replicate. And let's cut it off here. I like to show people features. If you group things, you can then crop them and it adds a realistic effect to the screen design. Now it's cut off and it looks like it's off the screen. So people will understand that it's intentionally leaving the screen and it's scrollable. One thing I want to do is this is intentionally larger with less content. This could have more content. So I think what I'm going to do is make it slimmer and I'm going to give my text more room. There's a lot of reasons why you want to be able to have space for the content. One thing I noticed is, okay, I've only have, what, 8 items in the menu here. I kind of want to play around with this because it's not enough. This is where wireframes are powerful because I can just make some simple changes. So like, and I can do the same here, or I can just copy and paste and just copy these. And then for now, I'm just going to do lorem ipsum for everything. And then I can sort of show all the different, I can show a lot more. So I added 4 more. And this will be great because if I scroll down further, it'll have this whole screen filled with these smaller ones. You still get the image. One thing we didn't add is the price. And I like to do the price over the image. So now I have like a restaurant menu. If I'm walking up to the screen, I easily see what I'm ordering from. I can pick from here and slide around, swipe around, and then tap into one of these and start ordering. All right, that's it. Thank you so much for joining me. Our next video is about designing alternates, diving into iterations. I will see you then.